It is 3 p.m. right here on KZSU Stanford, 90.1 FM, and it is the, the fifth season premiere of my weekly radio show, Arabology. This is DJ Ramzi, and as with all episodes of Arabology, we propose to you a virtual trip on a virtual carpet through the Arabic-speaking world, where we will be listening to the music that comes from that region, music that is often experimental, quite new to many listeners, but at the same time attempts to fuse East and West together in what I believe should be perfect harmony. This episode of Arabology, we will be bringing you an exclusive interview with Omar Offendum, who was at Stanford a couple of days ago, and we will be traveling all over the region to bring you goodies by such groups as Joussour and Zeid and the Wings. We'll be listening to Jerusalem in My Heart and to the amazing Elizabeth Ayoub. So stay with me. I'll be with you until 5 p.m. right here on the Arabology Show, coming to you from KZSU Stanford, 90.1 FM. Thank you.
تخشى النار من الجمر يا ولدي يا ولدي يا ولدي
Thank you.
3:15 right here on the Arabology Show, coming to you from KZSU Stanford 90.1 FM. I'm your DJ Ramzi, and you've been listening to a nice mix that began the first segment of the Arabology Show today, April 11th, 2013. I'm so happy you were able to join me. A very special happy birthday to Ahmad Q out there, who I know is celebrating his 28th birthday today. So كل سنة وأنت سالم وعقبال المئة يا Ahmad. And in terms of the music we just listened to, that was an amazing track by a Syrian group called Gene, spelled G-E-N-E as in genetic, and the track was called Ya Weladi, an amazing lyrics and tune that is sort of fueling the soundtrack to the Syrian revolution, and it's just an ode from a father to a son and telling him what is to come. So if you enjoyed that, check out their work. They're called the Gene Band, or simply Gene, G-E-N-E. Before that, we heard the Longa Farah Faza by Michel Sajrawy, and that was taken from his brand new album, Arab Pop. And if you haven't heard of this album, it's a highly original, energetic contribution to the genre of Oriental jazz. Sajrawy coined the term Arab pop for his fusion of Arabic and bebop sounds. Michel Sajrawy, who is a composer as well as a singer, he's also an electric bass player. He comes from Nazareth and he leads an Arab Jewish ensemble together. These include saxophonists Amiram Granot and Mali Klar, oudist Samir Makhoul, percussionist Wissam Arram and Valerie Lipetz on contrabass, and Stas Zilberman on drums. Put them all together and you have got Arab Pop. This album was actually produced and recorded in Nazareth. Before that, we heard, the Ensemble Maraghi, and that was a very short instrumental there called Ara Taksim. If you like that, then check out their album called Anwar. Anwar means lights, and it's basically features 15th century Islamic classical music from the Silk Road, featuring vocal styles and different vocal styles with three string long-necked flute called the sitar, and simple goblet drum called the zarb, and the frame drums, as well as the nai, which, if you don't know, is kind of a Middle Eastern flute or a reed. There we go. That was the Ensemble Maraghi and the track Ara Taksim. And we began the set, ladies and gentlemen, with that gorgeous instrumental by the group Joussour. Their name means bridges, and the track was called Under the Damascus Sky. That was taken from their album Places and Directions. And if you liked it, then check it out, because the album not only has instrumentals, but has gorgeous pieces set to music. And we may be able to squeeze in another track by Joussour later on, right here on the Arabology Show, coming to you from KZSU Stanford 90.1 FM. I'm your DJ Ramzi. And here's a small PSA, a short PSA for you. For years, Darfur has been embroiled in a conflict that has killed thousands and displaced millions more. Currently, more than 3 million women, men, and children are completely reliant on international aid for survival. You can get involved in a variety of ways, from writing to your elected representatives, to donating money, or starting action groups in your area. To find out more, please visit SaveDarfur.org. That's SaveDarfur.org. It is about 3:20 right here on the Arabology Show. I'm your DJ Ramzi, and for the first part of the show, we're going to let the music keep flowing in an Arabian-style flow, I guess. And for the second part of the show, I would remind everybody to stay tuned, because I do have an exclusive interview with none other than Syrian American Hip Hop artist, poet extraordinaire, Omar Offendum, and I'll be bringing you that exclusive interview during the second part of my show, Arabology. So stay tuned for that. Ladies and gentlemen, let's go back to the music and let's let the music speak with drums.
Disastrous security,
Boy, that was a, well, I don't know what to call them, a group or a project named Jerusalem in My Heart. And the track we just heard was called Yudardiru Ra'i Walal Ghanam. Boy, that's a really difficult title to translate. It's like, well, let's see. He tickles the shepherd and not the sheep. I don't know. That's exactly what that means. Anyway, so if you liked it, check out their album. It's called Muhit al-Muhit, released on Constellation Records. And Muhit al-Muhit means surrounding the ocean. It's a really amazing album with a lot of experimentation. And apparently, Jerusalem in My Heart had been performing in many places, including Canada, mostly. And they're very well known for their highly visual shows. And this was really the first attempt to release a CD from their recordings. And I guess if you liked it, then definitely check out the rest of the album. You may even want to check their videos on YouTube to see the visual aspect of their music. Before that, we heard from the Egyptian project and from the album Ya Omar. It was a song called Minin Agibak. Let me tell you, the lyrics to that in English were by Jérôme Étanger, and the Arabic lyrics were by Sayed Imam. The composer is the same Monsieur Béranger who wrote the lyrics. In fact, Jérôme, and I hope I'm not destroying his name here, Ebranger, there we go, is actually very involved in the album. He produced it, and he's also engineered it, and he arranged all the songs. Let me get his name right. His name is Jérôme Étanger. One last time, Jérôme Étanger. And the musicians that you heard with him were Sayed Inam and Ragab Sadiq, Salama Metwelli, and of course, Monsieur Étanger. I can't believe I'm like not getting this guy's name. Monsieur Etanger himself. There we go. I hope I did him justice. The Egyptian Project, the album Ya Omar, and the track we heard was Minin Agibek. Before that, it was, Saffron, and then a song or a track called Trembling. Now, that is taken from the album Dawning, and it's really one of those hard-to-describe musical mashups, a marvelous mix of cultures and sounds featuring vocals and sax and piano, sitar, and, of course, the tabla, layered with the music coming in from the Arabic-speaking world, as well as India and Iran. The CD actually even includes some poetry by Rumi, and includes many artists working together, including Katayun Gudarzi on vocal, Kevin Hayes on piano, Shujaat Hussein Khan on sitar and vocal, Abhiman Kaushal on tabla, and Tim Rise, the tenor and soprano saxophone, bass clarinet, and also plays the Hungarian folk flute. So if you like them, check out their album. It's Saffron. The track was Trembling, and the album name is Dawning. This is DJ Ramzi. The show is Arabology, and this is actually the fifth season premiere episode of Arabology, which means that we've been around now for five academic quarters, bringing you music from the Arabic-speaking world. My very special thanks to everybody who wrote in to the show, or to me personally at the email. Check out the show's Facebook page at facebook.com/Arabology. And there you'll be able to make suggestions and give me feedback about the kind of music I'm playing here on the show. I come to you every Thursday from 3 p.m. till 5 p.m. And I will continue to do that throughout spring quarter. So always stay tuned to well, not only my show, but all the amazing shows we have right here for you on KZSU Stanford 90.1 FM. Ladies and gentlemen, Free Speech TV is an independent, publicly supported, nonprofit TV platform that reaches 35 million households in the U.S. Using both television and the internet, Free Speech TV inspires viewers to become civically engaged in building a more just, equitable, and sustainable society. You can get involved by joining an online community, subscribing to the e-guide or RSS feeds, sharing videos, or of course, making a donation. For more information, visit freespeech.org. That's freespeech.org. Okay, it's almost a quarter to 4 p.m. right here at Stanford University, and more specifically at KZSU Stanford 90.1 FM. And before I take you on the next leg of our virtual journey through Arabia, I'm going to ask you this question. Want to be on the radio? Would you like to screen the latest releases by artists out of the mainstream, or report on the news, or cover events of vital interest to the greater Stanford community, or perhaps develop computer apps for Stanford's college radio station? Well, then join us for the KZSU Spring Open House on Thursday, April 11th at 7 p.m. That is tonight. All Stanford students and local community members are welcome. KZSU is located in the basement of Memorial Auditorium, 551 Sarah Mall, Stanford, to the left of the Piggott Theater entrance. So join in for the fun again. That's this evening, Thursday, April 11th at 7 p.m. Feel free to come in if this interests you. At 4 p.m., ladies and gentlemen, I will be bringing you, as I promised, my exclusive interview with Omar Offendum, recorded just a couple of days ago, and we'll be also featuring some of his music right here on the Arabology Show. In the meantime, I'm sure many of you have missed Guinewa music. How's that for a segue? Yes, Guinewa music, known all over North Africa, especially in the Maghreb and in Morocco and Algeria. And so why don't we listen to a little bit of Guinewa and see where that takes us all over. Well, I'll just call it the Arabian Peninsula.
حدا غيري مش شايف إلا زبالي قاعد مش شايف إلا حالي مش شايف حدا غيري مش شايف إلا زبالي تعمل لي جنجر ولا انا اعمل لك شويكر حش تعمل لي شي شي يا خي ما بدي شي شي لا تعمل لي جنجر ولا انا اعمل لك شويكر حش تعمل لي شي شي يا خي ما بدي شي شي
حبيبي وانت بعيد عني روحي روحي بتروح مني حبيبي وانت بعيد عني روحي يا روحي بتروح مني ماهوش بإيدي غصب عني انك تكون بعيد عني ماهوش بإيدي غصب عني انك تكون بعيد عني روحي يا روحي بتروح مني والشوق يزود
في غير
That was an amazing track by an amazing singer. Her name is Elizabeth Ayoub, and the song was called Ya'oud. The oud, of course, is the Middle Eastern instrument that you heard accompanying her beautiful vocals, and that was taken from her album titled Oceanus y Lunas, which I guess means oceans and moons. And if you want to know more about Elizabeth Ayoub, check out her two albums. She has two CDs out so far, hopefully working on a third. She's a singer-songwriter in Spanish, Arabic, and English, and she blends traditional sounds with contemporary ones. She was born in Venezuela to Lebanese immigrants, and she continues to make beautiful music today. Elizabeth Ayoub, if you're listening, please keep the beautiful music coming. Before that, it was the Egyptian Project and a track called Ya Omar. It happens to be the title track to their album Ya Omar. Before that, the Lebanese group Mashrou Leila, a song called The Wajeh or Wajeh. Well, I guess it's My Face. Either way, it's from their album El Hal Romansi. And we began the set with the Orchestra Arab de Barcelona and a song called Maghribia. Maghribia means Moroccan girl, and that was taken from their album Libertad, which means freedom. I'm your DJ Ramzi, and the show is Arabology. We are entering the second half of the show, and I'll be with you until 5 p.m. And for the second hand, for the second part of the show, I thought we would speed things up just a little bit because I'm about to play my interview with Omar Offendum. So let's listen to him welcoming us to Damascus, and that will lead us to our interview with Omar right here on the Arabology Show, coming to you from KZSU Stanford, 94.1 FM.
Our first impression of Damascus is one of surprise as we notice the modern appearance of the Saraya Square in the center of the city. But our opinion soon changes as we step a few paces away.
Hadi dimashq, wa hadi al-katsu wa al-rahu, inni uhibbu, wa ba'd al-hubbi dabahu, hadi dimashq. flows and rapid flows that's apropos until the water's open to them.
That's for sure.
Identity of Erebus resembling a window, though. Is there no Festivus for the rest of his history books can show? What will remain of poetry's originality if so? Many a brown nose and liar gets to have complete control. How we gon' ever write a verse to spit when killers still approach? I bore the burden of my words upon my back until I grieve. What shall remain of poetry when it is finally relieved? The saddest thing in this world, my lady, is knowing that we were meant to be from the very start.
Cosa más triste de este mundo, y así me siento yo por ti, solo por ti.
And this is how I feel for you.
No.
That was none other than Syrian American, rapper and hip-hop artist, poet, and many, many more things, Omar Offendum, singing the song Damascus. In Arabic, it's Dimashq. And it was taken from his album Syrian Americana, which an album that was released, I think maybe a couple of years ago, but still is getting quite a bit of critical acclaim, especially with everything that's going on in Syria. So if you liked his style, please do check out the album Syrian Americana. And speaking of Omar Offendum, he was actually at Stanford a couple of days ago and performed there as part of the Tradition and Modernity Globalization of Hip Hop event with a special spotlight on the Middle East. He performed some of his tunes and really energized the audience, which was mainly made of students here at Stanford. The event was organized by none other than the fabulous Farah Wehbe, who was a student at Stanford, and for that we all say a huge shukran, and shukran to Farah also for inviting me to moderate the event, which took place at Robley Hall so last Saturday. So Omar Offendum kindly agreed to give me an interview on his way to the airport, and if you know yours truly, I will do anything for an interview, it seems, because I conducted the interview in the car as I was driving Omar Offendum to San Francisco Airport right after his performance. So here we're going to try to do this, ladies and gentlemen, bring you an exclusive interview with Omar Offendum, and if you hear some screeches and tires and cars, I don't know, honking, then you know why that is. We were in the car on the 280 headed to SFO. But nevertheless, we were able to interview him right here on the Arabology Show. Coming to you from KZSU Stanford 94 FM, I'm about to play that very interview with Omar Offendum, for which I thank him wholeheartedly, shukran, as well as the group DAM, D-A-M, of course, the Palestinian hip-hop group that also was here with Omar Offendum, and who gave an unforgettable performance right here at Robley Hall at Stanford that same Saturday. So thank you to all these amazing young artists for coming to Stanford, energizing everybody, and for the amazing music that they released. Here is my interview with Omar Offendum, conducted on the run on the 280 freeway. So I'm actually sitting in my car today with Omar Offendum, who I guess is probably the most gracious person we can meet. He's agreed to give me an interview as we drive in the car to San Francisco Airport. Omar was here the last few days along with the Palestinian hip-hop group DAM, and they performed yesterday in concert here at Stanford. And my first question to Omar was, how did you feel about the performance, the turnout, and the students here at Stanford?
Well, first of all, I just wanted to say thank you to Stanford and to the students and the organizers and the sponsors who put the event together. And of course, thank you, Dr. Salti, for having me on the show again. It's an honor to be back. I had a wonderful time last night. It was really just kind of coming full circle, because I came and performed here at Stanford 2 years ago, and there was a student named Farah who came up to me afterwards and said she was really inspired by my work, and she ended up finding out more about me, bought my album later, and we stayed in touch online. She was saying how she was trying her best to get me back to campus to perform. And sure enough, almost 2 years later, it finally happened. And she joked how she said Stanford basically paid her to put on a party or a concert for her best artist and bring all her friends. And so it was a lot of fun. We had a great time. It was a really good turnout, very enthusiastic crowd, very diverse crowd. And everybody genuinely enjoyed both the discussion and the performance. And I always love performing with them. I've known them for a long time. They're great guys. And it's great to see them evolving with their music and in just their lives and their art in general.
Omar, your album, your CD, of course, Syrian Americana, is a staple here at KZSU Stanford 90.1 FM. It plays on hip-hop shows, on world music shows, on political shows, and it's considered generally to be this gem that you actually recorded way before the well, the current state of affairs in Syria. How much of the album informs maybe the situation in Syria, both when you recorded it and maybe prophetically now?
You know, that's a really good question. A lot of people who are just finding out about me now because of some of the songs I created after the Arab Revolution started, you know, they find Syrian Americana and they assume that it was done after. And they see, or they hear a lot of the material in it, and they say it relates to what's happening now. And to me, I mean, that's not really surprising, because these situations have built up over a long period of time. You know, in the case of Syria, the dictatorship is almost as old as I am, you know, or 10 years older than me. And so the things that I would talk about in the songs, the issues that I would, you know, wish were being expressed in you know, in the Arab world before these revolutions began, were things that I was able to talk about freely because I live in the United States. I grew up here. And so when I'm making music about what's happening there, I had more of a freedom, perhaps, than some people who are there on the ground. And so I talked about things in a very honest way, I felt. And to see that it applies to what's happening today isn't a surprise, because I see the same thing happen with the poetry of the people that I admire, whether it's Langston Hughes or Nizar Abani. It's almost as if some of their words are written today when I apply them to the events taking place. And I think, you know, all art that strives to be kind of, I guess, timeless in a way, if you will, it can relate to different phases, you know. When it speaks to like a universal truth, the suffering of a human being is something that's relatable in any conflict, you know, and it doesn't really have a nationality or a border. A person suffering, a baby crying, an orphan, a mother who's crying over her lost son, it's the same emotions and feelings that are felt from Vietnam to, you know, West Africa. It's the same. And so when art can kind of capture that emotion and that raw emotion, it's going to be relatable to people, you know. And so, you know, for me, it's an honor, really, to see how people have taken to the music and that the stuff that I wrote many years ago can still inspire people today. And it's also helpful because, honestly, when it comes to Syria, I've been experiencing a bit of a writer's block, and so I look back at my own material and kind of find solace in it, and I get empowered by it as well sometimes. And it reminds me of the bigger picture, you know, keeping things in perspective, so.
Because a lot of you, although, you know, you record music and the CD is out there, you also do many other things. You're involved in film and writing. And are there any projects on the horizon that you've been working on, perhaps, or thinking about since the release of Syrian Americana?
Definitely. Since the release of Syrian Americana, I've started working more closely with Sami Matar. He's a producer based in Southern California, a Palestinian-American composer and classically trained, also hip-hop producer. He scores music videos and film, video games and film. And him and I have been slowly working on an album over the last 2 years, just here and there in my time off from touring. And slowly working on this project. We've recorded more than enough material for an album, But that's something I generally like to do. I like to record a lot of songs and then slowly flesh out a record from the different, you know, things that I've created over the years. And so I'm working on that project with him, and I'm hoping sometime later this year we'd be able to release it. It'll be my follow-up album, I guess, my sophomore album, if you will. But it's also the first time I'm working with one producer. And so it's a cool opportunity to be able to work with just one person, and especially somebody who's classically trained, where you can literally just give them an emotion or a color and they can pull music from that idea. Other stuff I'm working on is a very short release I'll be putting out soon featuring poets from the Arab world over my beats. And this is something I worked on a DJ, or worked with a DJ with. Worked with a DJ on. His name is DJ Boo. He's actually Filipino, doesn't speak Arabic. And it was an interesting process to see how he took what he gathered from the things they were saying in terms of just raw emotion and was able to kind of infer what would be worth highlighting and wouldn't, based off the way that they were just even pronouncing and reciting the poems. And he was spot on, you know, and it showed me once again that you don't even have to speak the language to be able to connect with somebody when it comes to art. And that's something that's really beautiful. On that note, that's actually something that I heard a lot based off of a video that we just released a couple days ago, actually. Shadia Mansour, a very talented Palestinian, British artist, released a song that I'm featured on and a video for it a couple days ago called Lazim Nitghayyar, We Have to Change. And in the comments, you can see people saying over and over again how they don't even need to be able to speak the language to understand, because the song's entirely in Arabic. And so that's something that I've really enjoyed seeing. And as far as other projects I'm working on, I'm always on tour performing, from festivals to university shows. I've got a lot of ideas for videos I'll be releasing over the course of the year as well. And, you know, just growing as a person and as an artist and letting my life influence my art and my art influence my life, if you will.
And you're going to be back at Stanford May 13th. Omar, can you tell us a little bit about that event?
That's right. I'll be back at Stanford May 13th. At an event that is being hosted by some two professors on campus, Jeff Chang and H. Sami Alim. And they'll be hosting both me and Professor Sohail Daulatsai from UCI, from UC Irvine, who's recently released a book on hip-hop and the Muslim experience, the Black Muslim international experience. And so we're going to be having a conversation about hip-hop and about improvisation and about the Black Muslim international experience, if you will, in hip-hop music and in culture in general. So I'm really looking forward to it. They're all people that I really look up to and I really admire for their own work, their own academic work, and their love for hip-hop and their genuine love for hip-hop culture. And so it's going to be a great experience. That's on May 13th. That's a Monday. And I'm looking forward to coming back.
Track, am I correct, after Syrian Americana, like a separate single or track that we talked about? I may be wrong here, but wasn't there a certain song that you released after the album?
You mean hashtag Syria or
yes,
or the Egyptian Revolution song? Yeah, I released a couple of songs after Syrian Americana as singles that were really just kind of shows of solidarity with the people protesting in the Middle East. Some in English, some in Arabic. The English ones include hashtag Jan25 or January 25th, produced by Sami Matar and featured a bunch of really great artists from North America. Amir Suleiman, a spoken word, Def Jam poet. The Narcissist, an Iraqi rapper from Montreal. Freeway, a really big hip-hop artist from Philadelphia. And Aya, a Palestinian-Canadian R&B singer from Toronto. And we all kind of came together, not physically, we actually all recorded it separately, but came together on this one track and showed solidarity with the people in Egypt protesting, and actually released it before Hosni Mubarak had stepped down. And so it was a really beautiful way to kind of commemorate what was happening and show our solidarity with them. And then about a year later, I released hashtag Syria, which was a song that just featured me, also produced by Sami Matar, about what was happening in Syria, and also about the culmination of the events over the past 30 years leading up to it, and 40 years of dictatorship.
So we hope to bring those songs right here on the Arabology Show to our listeners. Omar is giving me this car interview is indicative of the kind of person you are. You've been going from talk to talk, meeting people, always smiling and empowering. Thank you so much for giving me this car interview. And for our listeners, the noises you may hear are proof that we are in a moving car right here on the 280. Omar, thank you very much, and for being such an amazing person and for being so loyal to the Arabology show. We truly appreciate it here on KZSU.
The pleasure is all mine. Thanks for having me again. Thanks for being both a great interview host and a safe driver. And for those who are listening, know that we also have two fabulous interns in the car with us. So don't worry, both his hands are on the steering wheel.
Yes.
We'll make it to the airport soon enough.
Definitely. Yeah. We have Samar Ahmad and Ahmad Kousi in the car. So, all right, thank you.
جلست والخوف بعينيها تتأمل فنجان المقلوب قالت يا ولدي لا تحزن فالحب عليك هو المكتوب She sat with staring both her eyes, pondering this Turkish coffee cup inverted. Carefully she worded destiny and time. Don't you grieve, my son, for love is written for you in the signs. Martyrdom for he who dies religiously, but love is blind. Your coffee cup is terrifying, a life of traveling and battling. A lot of love, a lot of death, a load of pain unravels as you're chasing after every woman on the planet, only to return like a defeated king, lascivious and lonely. Love is free, why the fortune teller charge me a fee just to say that? Love, but nobody's willing to reciprocate, I guess it's payback. Now when your future is a girl whose eyes alone could make you praise the Lord, lips shaped like grapes, beautiful, her laugh is musical, and still the sky above's a gloomy gray, the rains and pours, roadblock, deadlocked, immutable, a sight unusual, the woman of your dreams, sleeping in a palace tower, guarded by both thoughts and soldiers, like so which will make you cower, in the princess of your heart, in a slumber from the start, suitors lost, climbing fences to a brooder, who the fuck? Now I've read many poems and horoscopes before, but I have never seen a coffee cup resembling your coffee cup, I've never seeing sorrows like the sorrows emanating from this demi-tasse. Your destiny's to walk on dagger tips of love so many times. The solitude of seashells and the weeping willow. We will see you sucking currents of an oceanic love for females. The details you love and lose a million times, only to return like a dethroned king, lascivious and lonely. Love is free, why the fortune teller charge me a fee just to say that? Love, but nobody's willing to reciprocate, I guess it's payback. I read between the lines like fortune tellers with a coffee cup, and I ain't talking about them frappuccinos with that frothy stuff. Our peoples are of equal standing in the eyes of God we trust, but we're the ones who shoulder blame when errorism's army busts. I'm sick of asking why, when a kick of bashing fly. When a man is rich, weather and golden knowledge, he should try to treat the poverty of other brothers with consideration, knowing that the highest form of flattery is imitation. It's another iteration of the same bitter taste with the same limitations. Faint recollections of her face in a lace, in the bars of the jail where there ain't visitation. Man, I hate being patient, rather be the doctor. Diagnose a higher dose of mea culpa, not your general hospital, scrubbing soap or opera. Your local Asta, connect the dot, hope for God is within John. Love is free, why the fortune teller charge me a fee just to say that? Love, but nobody's willing to reciprocate, I guess it's payback. مقدورك أن تمضي أبدا في بحر الحب بغير قلوع وتحب ملايين المرات وترجع كالملك المخلوع.
That was Omar Offendum and a track called Finjan. Finjan in Arabic means coffee cup. And it was quite a track, actually. It's included on his Syrian American album. And, well, the lyrics in English were definitely Omar Offendum's, but they were kind of a translation from the original lyrics that you heard in Arabic at the beginning of the song. And those lyrics were by a poet named Nizar Qabbani, who is probably one of the greatest modern poets in Arabic literature. Nizar Qabbani wrote the song Qari'at al-Finjan many decades ago. And the song was later recorded in the 70s by a very, very well-known singer from Egypt. His name was Abdel Halim Hafiz. So Abdel Halim Hafiz would always perform in concert and would always perform this song called Qari'at al-Finjan, based on the Nizar Qabbani lyrics. And, you know, by now, Nizar Qabbani and Abdel Halim Hafiz have both passed away. Well, here comes young Omar Offendum, who takes the lyrics from Nizar Qabbani, and perhaps inspired by Abdel Halim Hafiz himself, he records this track, which he calls Finjan. And if you listen to the lyrics in English, it kind of mirrors with the original lyrics about a young man who goes to a coffee cup reader in, well, an Arab country, and asks her to look in his coffee cup to tell the future. So that's kind of a custom that, well, some people believe in and other people do just for fun. But basically, you have to drink your own coffee cup in those, you know, small, like espresso kind of cup, what we call Turkish coffee there, I guess. And after you're done, you don't drink the mud that forms at the bottom of the coffee cup. Instead, you invert it, you turn it upside down, and you put it in the little saucer, and you let it sit still. And as the muddy texture drapes down the inside of the cup, it forms certain shapes and images. And then the coffee cup reader supposedly can look at those shapes and tell you things about you that only you would know, and tell you where you've been and where you're going. Well, that's exactly what happens in this poem called Qari'at al-Finjan. The young man is actually visiting a coffee cup reader who looks at his cup and tells him that she has never seen such a coffee cup, because she sees so much intensity and passion in his life. She's going to truly, truly fall in love and madly fall in love, but it will never, ever work out for him. The intensity of the love he's going to feel will only be balanced by the intensity of disappointment he's going to constantly feel. Yet he's never going to give up and keep going to battle, and he's going to keep trying to find, well, I guess, true love, only to be disappointed. So that's kind of the gist of the lyrics by Nizar Qabbani, and Omar Effendi played with them really well on the album Syrian Americana by translating them into English and making them maybe a little bit of more relatable to Western audiences. Anyway, Omar Effendi has been or was my guest, my special guest for the interview on today's episode of Arabology. Hope you enjoyed that interview that I conducted with him in the car right after his performance here at Stanford on last Saturday. And my very, very special thanks to him and to the Palestinian hip-hop group Dam, who also were performing at the same time and who really, really energized, well, the room, if not the entire campus, let's say. Dam, who are actually Mahmoud Jreri and Tamir Nafar, as well as Suhail Nafar, three amazing young men. I would like to salute you and say shukran for coming to Stanford and for your amazing performance at Robley Hall. Otherwise, it's coming up to 4:30 p.m. here on KZSU Stanford, 94 FM. My name is DJ Ramzi. The show's Arabology, and I would like to say hello not only to Khalid Sayed, who, of course, is a listener of our show and has been a guest. He's a director, and he's Egyptian. So I wanted to say a quick hello to him and thank you for, the shout-out on the Arabology Arabology Facebook page. Thanks for that. إزيك يا أخي. إن شاء الله أنت بخير. Just a quick salutation to Khaled. I also wanted to say thank you to the person that wrote about the show as they were listening. Let's see if I can figure it out. Yes, it is Arundhati Chakravorty. I hope I didn't butcher your name, but thank you so much for listening and for writing in for the show. Apparently, the piece with the tabla that you heard kind of caught people's attention, so I'm glad you enjoyed that. Ladies and gentlemen, when you're listening to the Arabology show, and I know that I go through names very quickly and song titles, and most people who don't speak Arabic will be completely lost, fear not, because you could always go to kzsu.stanford.edu, and there you can see what song is currently playing, or you could go to zookeeper.stanford.edu, and there's a link for playlists. If you click on that link, you'll be able to get the playlist for any show at any time here at Stanford, not just my show, but all shows. And you'll be able to kind of see how the names are spelled and what album they come from and what record company, etc., or CD company, I guess. So do check out zookeeper.stanford.edu. Click on the playlists link, and from there you can navigate to any playlist from any show, including the show that I'm playing right now. So as I'm live on the air, we are trying to keep current and enter the current track that you're listening to. Anything you like, feel free to further explore. And thanks again for tuning in to the fifth season, first episode of Arabology right here on KZSU Stanford 94.1 FM. Why do you listen to KZSU? Is it the music you can't hear anywhere else? The Stanford sports broadcasts, from football and women's and men's basketball to volleyball? Or perhaps it's our coverage of news and public affairs affecting the Stanford community? Your underwriting not only helps keep KZSU on the air, but you'll also enjoy a little exposure and goodwill for your business or professional practice. For more information, email underwriting@kzsu.stanford.edu or call 650-723-9010. Or email again, underwriting@kzsu.stanford.edu. And one last thing going on April 15th, that's Monday evening at 7:30 p.m. at the Oshman Family Jewish Community Center in Palo Alto, the wind ensemble Califax will perform. The ensemble includes oboe, clarinet, saxophone, bassoon, and bass clarinet, and transcribes their wide-ranging repertoire. For tickets or information regarding this April 15th Wind Ensemble recital at the Oshman Jewish Community Center, call 650-223-8699. That's 650-223-8699. Or visit paloaltojcc.org. Once again, that's paloaltojcc.org. Ladies and gentlemen, if you were listening to the Omar Offendum interview and the track that I played, you might have heard him refer to a song that he released after his album, Syrian Americana, that was called Hashtag Syria. And it's a pretty powerful track. It's against the current regime in Syria. So it's sort of an anti-Bashar al-Assad track that he actually played and performed right here at Stanford on Saturday. The track is not part of an album, but it was recorded along with a talented producer named Sami Matar, and together they released the track Hashtag Syria. I'm about to play that track after telling you a little bit about Omar Offendum himself. He's known as Omar Shakaki, and he's a Syrian American hip-hop artist, architect, educator, and activist. He was was born in Saudi Arabia and then was raised in Washington, D.C. Omar Offendum began his career as part of the Nomads duo with fellow artist Mr. Tibbs. He subsequently became active in a number of fundraising and community education projects, including co-producing the Free the P mixtape, participating in the Arab Summit project, and becoming involved with Nomadic Wax's school tours. In an attempt to bridge the divide between Western and Arabic cultures and provide an understanding between the two cultures, he translates classical Arabic poetry into English and vice versa. Omar Offendum has had a diverse group of artists who have inspired his work and which contribute to his diversity. Hip-hop groups such as Public Enemy and reggae artists like Bob Marley have inspired him in one way or another. American artists, though, were not his only inspiration. He's had several Arabic classical musicians such as Abdel Halim, Ali Shabana, Kulthum, and I'm going to say also Abdel Halim Hafez, and of course Fayrouz. He is also inspired by poets such as Langston Hughes, and whose poetry is actually included on Syrian Americana, ladies and gentlemen, as well as Nizar Qabbani, of course, a Syrian poet who wrote the lyrics to the track Finjan that you heard a little earlier in the show. Omar Effendim's song, hashtag January 25th, JAN25, inspired by the Arab Spring uprisings in Egypt, became popular in 2011. It actually went viral on the internet and sort of contributed towards the spread of international hip-hop. It was released in February 2011, shortly before the resignation of Egyptian president at the time, Hosni Mubarak. Omar Offendum has often also collaborated with Yassin Al-Salman, also known as The Narcissist, and Shadia Mansour, a.k.a. the First Lady of Arabic hip-hop. His officially released solo album, Syrian Americana, was released in 2011, and a little while later, he released Hashtag Syria, and I think we should listen to that while saying one last time, shukran to Omar Offendum for the interview. Shukran to the group Dam. Maybe we'll hear from them next in terms of playing one of their songs right here on the Arabology Show in the second part of the show. I'm your DJ Ramzi. The show is Arabology, and here is Hashtag Syria by Omar Offendum. Enjoy.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ومن هالرجيم الشيطان اللعين And the people united will never be defeated I will shout you read the spot on your arm shout you read the spot on your arm shout you read the spot on your arm ملينا من خلقك على الحرام listen The purpose of these verses is to unify the masses. Humps up to Hasak, Ibn Yas to Damascus. City streets to countryside, mountaintops to coastal tides. Muslim, Christian, women, men, and children, let's keep hope alive. Stand in solidarity with all your fellow citizens. Peacefully protesting for an end to all the militants. Torturing, imprisonment, murdering of innocents. Proving that those lying leaders, rulers, illegitimate. Like father, like son, mobster, a president. Censoring their people, trying to stop the embezzlement. Heavy-handed iron fist dropped on the residents. Deja vu. 82 or 11 and we are all there to Zor, we are all Dara, we are all just as Hur, Halab and the Al-Az, we are all Hamza, we are all Hama, we are all Syrian, hands to the summer saying
Shout, you read, you spot on your arm, Shout, you read, you spot on your arm, Shout, you read, you spot on your arm,
and the people united will never be defeated, I will
Shout, you read, you spot on your arm, Shout, you read, you spot on your arm, Shout, you read, you
Now I have a dream the regime will fall And that what comes next is gonna be better for us all Alawi, Dirzi, Armeni, Kirdi Equality in parliament, Kul Elo Kirsi Envisioning a future that's brighter for the youth Who've been fighting for the right to shed light upon the truth Biting bullets from the troops thus far A truce has proven elusive
but martyrs, the titan in the noose. On corruption, bribery, nepotism, tribal disputes. Don't shoot with your mechanism, soon comes the reckoning that looms. Second guessing the protesters was a recipe for Essa to address his own doom. It's been a long time coming and there's no turning back now. Voices are the weapons in these military crackdowns. Millions on the streets in defiance of your gas sounds. Look who's got you shook, doctor, don't know how to act now. United, we'll never be defeated. I'm a shot.
You hear the spark on your bomb. A shot. You hear the spark on your bomb. A shot. You hear the spark on your bomb.
The land of Lincoln took on your land.
يا كذاب وتضرب انت وهالخطاب الحرية صارت عالباب ويلا ارحل يا ماهر ويا جبان ويا عميل الشيطان الشعب السوري ما بينهان ويلا ارحل يا بشار طز فيك طز باللي بيحييك لك والله بعرف طلع فيك ويلا ارحل يا بشار حاجة تدور دمك في حمامة مهدور وخطأك مانو مغفور ويلا ارحل.
That was a powerful track by Omar Offendum, and it was called Syria Hashtag. And that concludes my spotlight on Omar Offendum on this week's episode of Arabology, the show that comes to you every Thursday from 3 p.m. till 5 p.m. right here on KZSU Stanford 90.1 FM. Here is the Palestinian hip-hop group Dam, who also were here, spelled D-A-M. And enjoy their hip-hop song as we begin the countdown towards the end of the show today on the Arabology Show. This is DJ Ramzi. I'm so glad you're with me. Please stay tuned for Emma and Sunflower Sutra at 5 p.m. right after my show, right here on KZSU Stanford.
أول إشي لازم نمتلكوا هي المبادرة اسمعي فهم استطلت تدار تناديها محاضرة احنا في مصارة اللي من زمان ثبتونا فيها بينادوها مامرة وعدم وعلي خليها أعرفكم عن نفسنا من بلد اسمها اللي فيها اللي بوتها ما بدفع التمن وفيها اللي بهدلل ناس اللي عملوا غلطوا بنوا عرضهم وكل اللي بيصير بس عشانهم لوحدهم غير وقف على موقف اللي شرف ودير العقول ويبدأ فهم إنه القوة بالمجمع ولا مرة بالمفرد وعادة إذا فكرنا هيك احنا بمفرد عن الكل والغلط إنه فكرنا بالكل بس هذا الغلط لأنه صح ولازم ودوم ولما قلنا ايدي بايد ما كانش قصنا اصبع ولا تاخد لازم تطلب والقوة بالمجمع
مع انه حارتنا خجولة ومش لابسة حرير عصبرة طرحة دورها للتجميل الزمن سبقها نسيها ملها التفريق صار قصير راح يكسر قفص واخيرته يحلق ويطير
هدمي بيوت زي الهمس تكون كل ما ضل بسكوت دان الشعب بتفوت بس لو صرخ لا بغرقها في ظهر الحق اسمع بقدر افهم كل عيوني اللي من حزن تدمع بس ما بفهم اللي ما يمسح عيونه تايه يسأل على اليابسة هو قاعد يجدف في دموعه ايش بيصير هنا مال الكل يطلع علينا
يمكن عشان احنا اللي فاتحين جرينا
يا زلم المرة هديك مظاهرة ضد هدم بيوت كان فيها 100 واحد 90 منهم يهود اذا اليوم بتوقف تطلع كيف قاعدين بيهجروا جارك بكرة اربع دارك جارك زيك واقف تطلع مكانك السلسلة طويلة بس الها اخر سقوط للقدرة العاجزة شايفة عارفة بس خايفة اذا الروح فينا ساكنة تفلط بس السكنة وش بنقول للحلقة الاضعف مع السلامة
مع انه حارتنا خجولة ومش لابسة حرير عروس برا طرحة
حياتنا بتميل الصهيونية اللي تنزل فينا وسخها واحنا عمالنا ننستن ولا حدا بيفتح المي ولا حتى احنا والوسخ بيكتر اكتر واكتر هاي اللحظة برجع من وين ما اجا بس كل ما يقرب على الافا الفعل بيصير مفعول فيه وبس بنظف القريب عليه بتأمل انه مرة كله يفور برا تشديدا على كلمة كله وهيك الكل بيوقف عجري وهيك احنا بنوقف الجدار وهيك احنا بنوقف القطار وسكة الحديد بتصير بعيد عن الدار وبرضه بنوقف
خجولة ومش لابسة حرير عروس برا طرحة دورها للتجميل
بالنوم أحلام غميقة منك شامم ريحة الحريقة اشتعل نار عند الجيران ما حدا فاق ما حدا اهتم
That was a very special track, ladies and gentlemen, by Zeid and the Wings. Zeid, of course, Zeid Hamdan, who is a musical genius from Lebanon, and someone who's done so much for his, relatively young age. Zeid Hamdan was kind and generous enough to send us this track named Jazeera, and that track is actually unreleased yet. Before that, it was the group Dam featuring Abir Zinati. And it was a song called Hon in Walet, Born Here. We heard the Arabic version. I believe there's also a Hebrew version to that song. Ladies and gentlemen, we've got about 10 minutes to go right here on the Arabology show. And I'm about to give away two tickets to a concert that is in New York. So normally we wouldn't do that here at KZSU since we are at Stanford University. But we do happen to have two tickets that we're going to give away to Mike Massy, who is, of course, a Lebanese singer and a very talented musician and artist and songwriter and actor and dancer, and I could go on and on. In any case, he's going to be at the Merkin Concert Hall at Kauffman Music Center. That's in New York, and that's going to be on Thursday, April 25th at 8 p.m. So if you are interested in two tickets to this concert, if you're going to be in New York, or you know someone in New York to whom who would like to attend it, please be the second caller to the station. You can call us at 650-723-9010 to win two tickets to the Mike Massey concert, which is going to take place in New York at the Merkin Concert Hall on April 25th. The number again is 650-723-9010. And as we listen to a track by Mike Massey, might be a great time to call if you are interested in these two tickets right here on the Arabology Show. Thank you for listening.
Ya zaman, ya zaman, ya zaman, ya zaman, ya zaman, ya zaman. زمن يا زمن يا زمان يا زمن يا زمان يا زمان يا زمن يا زمان يا زمان يا زمن يا زمان يا زمان.
That was Mike Massy and a song called Ya Zaman. It's actually also the title to his CD, Ya Zaman. And again, if you're interested in two tickets to his concert in New York, then feel free to call within the next 5 minutes right here at KZSU. The number is 650-723-9010. And you could win two tickets to Mike Massy in concert. That's Thursday, April 25th. At 8 p.m. at the Merkin Concert Hall at Kauffman Music Center in New York. Ladies and gentlemen, as I wind down the show, I am going to play a song by Aswat. And if you've heard of this vocal ensemble, well, they started in the Bay Area and they are amazing. They've been touring, and on next week's show, I will be giving two tickets to one of their concerts. So if you like what you're about to hear, then tune in to next week's show of Arabology for your chance to win two tickets to their concert, which is going to take place on April 20th, 2013 at 7:30 p.m. And that concert will feature the Aswat Sacred Music Ensemble, Mohammed Nijad Ensemble, and Mete Bayigit Ensemble. So if you like that, it's going to be Saturday, April 20th at 7:30 p.m. at Zaytuna College, located in Berkeley, California. Two tickets to that concert will be given away on next week's show on Arabology, so definitely check back with me next week. I'm going to leave you with a song by Aswat after a quick promo for their concert, and that'll take us to 5 p.m. time for the one and only Emma and Sunflower Sutra. She is back, and boy, does she have a good show for you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. This is DJ Ramzi. The show is Arabology, and I thank you for tuning in. Shukran, merci, and au revoir.
In celebration of women in Arab music, the Bay Area's premier Arabic music ensemble, Aswat, presents a concert in tribute to the two musical legends Kulsoom and Fairuz. On Sunday, May 5th at 3 p.m. at the College of San Mateo Theater. Tickets are available online at brownpapertickets.com. For more information, visit www.zawaya.org.